Hello everyone, this is Robert with Team Copperhead, and in this video we're going to be talking about the fight recap between Kronos and Copperhead in the Bounty Hunter series. Of course, this video is going to contain spoilers, so go ahead and watch the whole Bounty Hunter series, and then come back and we will discuss this fight. So before I get to talking about the actual fight, let's talk about the Bounty Hunter episode specifically. So this is kind of the replacement to the Desperado tournament that happened last year and I think the year before that. It's basically just a way for builders to get a couple extra fights, and in this case, a little bit of extra cash. You actually won money for winning these fights. We signed up and we pretty much knew that we were going to be in the Son of Waiachi bracket. The producers, you know, it was pretty obvious that they were going to match us up with that because of past history. Last year, Son of Waiachi is the one that knocked us out of the tournament. And then in previous years with Poison Arrow, we actually knocked out Son of Waiachi. So it was pretty obvious that that was going to happen based on just the history. Looking at this bracket, we noticed that we saw Kronos, Gigabyte, and Son of Waiachi. So if we ended up going really far in this, we knew that we were gonna have to face at least three horizontal spinners. So we were relying very heavily on that horizontal cross member that gets welded into the frame to prevent the splitting that happened last year. If you remember when we fought Kronos last time, they ended up getting a really nice hit and it just split the frame out. So that horizontal cross member was gonna be very key to these fights because we didn't wanna get split open again. So most of the preparation for this fight was done in the off season prior to us even getting to BattleBots. As I mentioned in my Copperhead overview video, we had that horizontal beam that would tie the two front forks together. And in addition to that, we actually chamfered the inside of those forks so that if someone came along and hit, hopefully it would kind of go up and over that. We knew we were susceptible to horizontals from last year, so we tried to fix some of those things. Luke ended up driving for this fight. He hadn't driven Copperhead yet, so you know, it was just kind of a good idea for him to get in there and drive this one. I was controlling the weapon because we didn't want to have what happened with Mammoth and Black Dragon to where, you know, someone really wasn't watching the weapon. So we decided to just kind of have a dedicated weapons operator just so we could see what the issues were with that weapon. And that turned out to be just fine. But yeah, Luke ended up driving this. I wish they would have said that on TV, but they didn't. So yeah, let's go into the actual fight itself. Thankfully, this fight went a lot better than it did last time. Luke did a really good job of getting up on them really quickly and just prevented their ring from getting up to speed and was just kind of on them, and then they ended up getting that one really good hit which flipped them upside down. I'm not really sure why Kronos, a ring spinner, can't drive effectively upside down. I'm not sure if something else happens there, but generally speaking with a ring spinner, the whole benefit to it is the wheels can actually protrude from the top, whereas opposed to a shell spinner, the shell completely covers the top and side. So theoretically they should have been able to drive upside down, but maybe they got high-sided or maybe something just kind of broke inside. But it was really down to that one first hit and then that second hit which flipped them upside down and they were completely done. So we were obviously pretty happy with this. Anytime you can not suffer any damage and get a nice good 30-second knockout, you're very happy because then you can just kind of move on and go into the next fight without any damage or repairs. So yeah, after this fight, we were one step closer to facing Son of Waiachi once again, and our next fight would be against either Kraken or Rusty, depending on whoever wins that fight. So be sure to check out the next fight recap for my recap on that. Be sure to check out the links down below for information about our sponsors, following Copperhead on Facebook, as well as following me on Facebook as well. Thanks for watching. See you next time.